everyone, I'm Bora Yoon. I'm the composer for this piece, Soundfield Celestine. It is an electroacoustic work that imagines a duet between land and sky, taking advantage of the fact that the Carillon is itself kind of a broadcasting tower of sound, and really taking advantage of the spatial acoustic qualities and to really animate the fact that music is like colored weather and the densities and the materiality and the spirituality that kind of swirls around with both of those things. The premiere is performed by Lisa Loney here at St. Thomas of White Marsh, and the Carillon piece is available to you in all different tunings to fit the Carillon system as per your performance. And we just want to especially thank the Guild of Carilloners of North America for commissioning this work as the first ever electroacoustic work in their series. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
everyone. My name is Lisa Loney, and I'm the carillonier here at St. Thomas Church, White Marsh. It is my privilege to be able to premiere Bora Yoon's piece, Sound Fields. She and I got together quite a few years ago and talked out this project. We did perform it live on occasion of a dedication of a music building at Princeton. And now, a couple of years later, it's available to you. And it's the first time ever that the GCNA has endeavored to make an electroacoustical piece available. So enjoy. Keep in mind that this carillon is in D, but no matter what carillon you play it at, it will sound spectacular. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, I am Gary White, and I became aware of the carillon in 1955 when I enrolled in the University of Kansas. I graduated from high school in a small town on the Oklahoma-Kansas border and went to KU to become a public school music teacher. We were very well aware of the carillon because the University Carillonneur Ronald Barnes gave a little concert at noon on most weekdays. I was intrigued by the sound of the bells and made acquaintance with Ron, and in due course he invited me up to the tower, showed me the bells, and demonstrated how to perform on the carillon. Roy Hamlin Johnson was on the piano faculty at the University of Kansas at that time, and I was assigned to Roy to get piano proficiency so that I could pass the keyboard proficiency examination that was required of all public school music teachers. So for a year or a year and a half, I had private lessons with Roy. And indeed, he did help me to get the skills I needed to pass the keyboard proficiency exam. But he gave me much more than that. I absorbed his enthusiasm for the structure of music. He was always talking about how Bartok had structured these little pieces that I was learning to play. And it was really through his enthusiasm that I began to set my sights a little higher than being a high school band director and thought about becoming a composer. Roy had just written his first work for carillon at that time, Summer Fanfares, and he showed me the score and we went over it. And he talked about the acoustics of the bells and how to write for the instrument. So I had essentially composition lessons for the carillon led by Ronald Barnes and Roy Hamlin Johnson. I can't imagine two better teachers. Roy became a very good friend of mine, and admired him for many of his accomplishments. Roy was a brilliant pianist. He was an inspired teacher. He was an excellent composer and one of the finest human beings I have been privileged to know. I hope that you enjoy my tribute to Roy. It is entitled Tribute to the Memory of Roy Hamlin Johnson. Thank you.
Thank you.